Welcome back to Mad Dog Air Guns. Today we have a very special video, the eagerly awaited. I know a lot of you have already seen it, a lot of you have already got it. There's plenty of videos out there on it already, but it's this. The Umarex HDX68. Now, we don't do unboxing videos on this channel, so there you go. So get rid of the box. As you'll notice, I've put a little red dot on it. It does come with these sights. They just come off easy as you like. So I've stuck a big old fat old red dot on the top of it. Just gives it a bit more of a... good red dot, this one. It's got three colours, red, green and blue. But I've not zeroed it in or anything. Anyway, this... listen to that sound. Is that good or is that good? Now there's plenty of reviews on this gun. The stock comes off. Two CO2s go in there. There is a little tool that sits in top. Goes in there like so. That's for doing the end here. Get it on and you can twist that off like so. Put your CO2s in, tighten it up, that can stay on there. Stock goes back on. So there's your pump action handle. Nice muzzle brake on it there. This thing in there has got the spring in it for your magazine. And you load it up from the side here. So you open it up and in the bottom of the handle, got this little bit of plastic here, look. Pull that out. Let me just bring you down here and have a look. That just sits in. No, is that the right way? No, that is the right way. No, I've not opened that up enough. Open it all the way up. And then that just slots down in there like that. You can load your balls in now. 16, I believe. We've not done that yet. But so you load your balls up, you take that out. And you're good to go. So then you just stick that back in the, I don't know which way around it goes, that way or that way. Just pushes down in there and that stays in your handle. Like so. Now this comes in at about 3 kilos, just over. The build quality of this is fantastic. I mean, the whole body is metal, plastic grip, plastic stock, plastic pump action thingy. Rail on the top, rail on the bottom. The build quality on these Umarex guns is fantastic, it really is. So, they come in 3 power versions, 7.5 joules, 16 joules, or 40 joules. Now, all 3 are available here in France. The 40 joule version you need a Cat C license for, which I haven't got yet. I was gonna be applying for it this month, but money's got a little bit tight, so, what version did I go for? Now, logically, you would think we'd go for the 16 joule version to get the most powerful one that you can without a license. But oh no, I went for the 7.5 joule version. This is just an unboxing. We're gonna shoot it through the Chrono and see what damage the 7.5 joule version will do to a pumpkin. So that's the plan. We're gonna get it loaded up and get it outside. Bit of silicone spray. First one goes in forwards. Second one goes in backwards. Screw the end back on. Give it a little nip up with this. Leave that on there. Put the stock on. Now it's not armed yet because we haven't punched the end. Make sure the safety's on. So, safety's on. That won't trigger now. Won't do anything. Oh no, we need to safety off, don't we? Twat. So, let's get this thing out of here. Open that all the way up. We're using 68 caliber rubber steel balls. It should just be a case of pushing them in. I don't know what we're up to. If I can get this one in, I'll leave it at that. Take that out. Must be full up. So, that's got one in the chamber. But we're not pressurised yet. Back in there. So there we go, safety's on. Now it's loaded, there's one in the chamber, but we've not punctured the CO2 yet. So we're gonna hit that when we get outside and shoot some through the chronograph and then see what it'll do to a pumpkin. See you outside. HDX 68 with metal balls. 6.89 grams. HDX 68 coming in very underpowered. A lot of that I think has got to do with the cold weather. It is bitterly cold out. It's about 2 to 3 degrees Celsius. I can't feel my fingers. It's not doing the CO2 any good whatsoever. I've just shot the HDX through it again and we're getting 12.28 joules, which from a 7.5 joule gun I think is very strange. I'll just try another shot. 13.5, 8.86, 10.42, empty. So before I was packing up, I thought I'll just empty the rounds in this and shoot them through the chronograph. We've got over 13 joules. This is only supposed to be a 7.5 joule gun. It's advertised as 7.5 joules on the box. It is still cold out here. I left it a long time between the shots. The last shot was 10.42 joules, which out of a 7.5 joule gun isn't quite bad, is it? So somewhere on here for it being 7.5 joules. It should have an F stamp on it. Yeah, it has. It's got the F stamp there in the Pentagon. So that's 7.5 joules. Now it's 6.89 grain metal hard balls, which I've set in the chronograph. I'm a bit perplexed at that. Anyway, I'm going to pack up and get indoors. Catch you in the next video. Bye for now.